I am a mountain. I am a tall tree. Oh, I am a swift wind sweeping the country. I am a river down in the valley. Oh, I am a vision, and I can see clearly. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope in the back against the ropes.
Please join me in giving the very warm welcome to this
house. I can feel it, I'm the world's greatest.
Good morning, Voyages South High School, class of 2016. So I want to start off by thanking the faculty and administration, and most importantly, the student body, for inviting me to come out and speak to you all again on such a joyous occasion. I feel extremely lucky to be back. And this is not my first time speaking at Voyages South High School. I have had the honor of taking wisdom from you all as I have shared knowledge that I have accumulated to help my peers as they go towards their journey to success. So to stand before you and to look at these familiar faces with familiar expressions of excitement, hopefulness, eagerness is something that's truly indescribable. As I have shared, more and more of us nameless have come together through the community I have built through my nonprofit organization, the Hustle Hard Campaign. Years ago, at the height of my high school social season, I was diagnosed with Crohn's disease and inflammatory bowel disease and began chemotherapy treatments to manage my conditions. So I had a squad of friends and they were lit. I had a boyfriend who was relatively fine and he adored me. And as I got sick, I found myself working harder and harder to hide the secret as hospital stays became days and then weeks, and that group of friends wasn't there for me so much anymore. That boyfriend who I thought was pretty cute wasn't there for me anymore. And I often had to have nurses come into my room to remove the textbooks under my slumped body because I would fall asleep after chemotherapy sessions, studying, and trying to keep up with my classes. So finally, an administrator counseled my family that it was probably in my best interest to take a break from school. Out of all the long nights, the embarrassing moments, the bullying I experienced, the isolation, the feeling like I could give up, should give up, this would seem like a merciful get out of jail free card for most. As I've worked with other ill students, I have seen that this option has been offered to far too many other students. Not only did I continue to be in the classroom, but I tested into one of the hardest academic high school programs in Texas, got my associate and my high school diploma by age 17, then moved on to St. John's University and was the youngest to ever walk that stage and get my Bachelor of Science by 19. I got my hair done, I got the fresh fade yesterday morning, we're here for me. I'm telling you guys this, not to brag or not to highlight only the success towards the end of the story, but I'm telling you this because I want to give you a glimpse into a real life. A life that gives me a distinct connection with each and every one of you. A life that has kept me coming back to the school frequently because in this brief synopsis of what was the most awful part of my life, I never let go to school, ever. So do you see what I'm saying? I held on to school when they told me the education will always be there. You don't even need an education to go into most career fields. I mean, at the end of the day, it seems like you're going through too much and school is putting more on you than you can handle. Voyages South, let me tell you, no matter what your dark period was, I don't know if this is your fourth year, I don't know if this is your sixth year, but what matters is that we are sitting here looking at the largest class to graduate from Voyages South High School. So, despite your dark period, what that tells me and everybody else looking at you is that we are brothers and sisters in the belief that no matter what you go through, if you continue to hold on to your dreams and you understand that education equals freedom, you will make it. You see what I'm talking about? That's what I see when I come here. And this is why I continue to come back, because you all embody the heart of my foundation. And it is that no bad thing, no adversity defines you. And it is in those moments that are your worst that you're supposed to reflect and remember that this is necessary. All the bad times, all the times in which you fall and can't get up, it is necessary. Because as you sit here today in your robes and you're looking around and you're laughing with your friends, you earned your seat at the table. You did your hard work. You came in when you thought you couldn't, or when your friends tried to bait you to maybe skip school and get into some shenanigans, and you realized you weren't about that life, and you walked these halls instead of walking those streets. That was the moment that you earned your seat at the table. Favorite, when you decided you want to do good, right? You want to do good. You want to help out around the house. You do your chores. You do your homework. You study it for the test. But every time you get a grade back from the professor, it's barely passing. And you don't understand why, when hard work does not equal success, what's wrong with that equation? God wanted you to stub your toe. He wanted you to be frustrated, because those are the moments that define you. It was when you kept studying, you kept doing your chores, you kept doing your homework, even though you were frustrated, that was when your character was built. So this moment, Voyages, as you all look seriously stunning, I want you to realize that this glorifies the heights of your good times and the depths of your lows. And I want you to take those things, take those experiences, and realize that there's somebody just like you somewhere. And they need to see that strength. And they need to see that you overcame those trials, because they're going through it and they don't think that they can. They don't think there's a way out, but you made it, you found it, you have the solution. So take these testimonies and wield them to help somebody else, because you all sitting here are so necessary. You're so necessary. Voyage yourself, you have a new name. You are alumni.
That's right.
Throughout your career, I'm gonna surprise you, but you're gonna get more names. Entrepreneur, yes. CEO, yes. Professor, yes. Boss. You're gonna get some new names, okay? They're coming your way. And we might see some people pursuing politics. That's luck. You don't just run up on luck. So,
I made it.
I'm the world's greatest.
Come and look at me.
I'm that little bit.